Walsingham Academy Theater and Trojan Media present The Tell-Tale Heart.
True, very, very dreadfully nervous. I've been and am. But why will you say that I am mad? The disease had sharpened my senses, not dulled them. I heard all things in heaven and in the earth. I heard many things in hell. How am I mad? It is impossible to say how first the idea entered my brain. But once conceived, it haunted me day and night. I loved the old man. He had never wronged me. I think it was his eye. Yes, it was this. It was a pale blue eye with a film over it. Whenever it fell upon me, my blood ran cold. So I made up my mind to take the life of the old man and rid myself of the eye forever. You fancy me mad, but you should have seen me. I was never kinder to the old man than during the week before I killed him.
How did you sleep?
Great.
Pancakes or waffles this morning?
French toast.
Sure.
Every night at midnight, I carefully turned the latch of his door and, oh, so slowly, put in a dark lantern so it wouldn't disturb his sleep. And carefully opened the lantern so a single ray of light would fall upon the eye. I did this for 7 nights, but the eye was always closed. So it was impossible to do the work, because it wasn't the man who vexed me, but his evil eye. On the 8th night, I was even more cautious. A watch's minute hand moves more quickly than mine did. Suddenly, he moved on the bed as if startled. You may think I drew back, but no, his room was dark. I was about to open the lantern, as I had every night before, but...
Who's there?
I kept still and said nothing. For an hour, I didn't move a muscle, and neither did he. He sat up hearkenly to the death watches in the wall.
Ugh!
Maybe it's just the wind. Or a deer mouse.
Squeak, squeak, squeak.
Or chicken. Or did someone Stanley fall over?
I still didn't hear him lie down. So I decided to open the lantern until a ray of light fell upon his evil eye. It was open, wide, wide open. I grew furious as I gazed upon it. It chilled my bones.
Shivered me timbers.
And was covered with a hideous veil. I could hear his heart beating in his chest, softly at first, then louder and louder. It was so loud I thought it would burst. What if a neighbor could hear it? Louder, 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 louder. I couldn't take it anymore.
He has no pulse. His eye will trouble me no more. Now I need to get rid of this body. Here, I'll tear up these floorboards and dismember the corpse. No body, no crime. Ha! Now he is hidden beneath the floorboards. It looks as good as new. Better than new. I'm cooked! Good morning, officers.
Ha! A neighbor might have heard some yapping.
Do you know anything about that?
I'm Jake from State Farm.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
So, can we come in and have a look?
Come on in, let me make some hot chocolate.
So what exactly happened to you tonight?
I had a bad dream, and I screamed like a little girl. Eee!
That's okay, we believe you.
So where's the old man?
He's on vacay, in the Bahamas. Must be nice, here's his room. Let's have our hot cocoa in here. As you can see, nothing is stolen. Everything is okay. Nothing to see here. Here's a chair.
Oh, thank you for this hot chocolate.
What is that sound? They have to be mocking me. They know what I did. They're laughing behind my back or right in front of me. Either way, they're laughing. Dissemble no more. I admit the deed. Tear up the planks. Here it is. The beating of his hideous heart.
Ladies and gentlemen, here is a swift recap of a telltale heart.
I could hear his heart beating all too well, so I wrapped my cardigan around me. And even though it could ruin my reputation, I guess you can say I did something bad. Now he's lying on the cold, hard ground, and I know places to hide him. No body, no crime.
I knew the officers were trouble when they walked in. Something's gone terribly wrong. Can't turn back now. I'm haunted.